Sea King, for anti-submarine warfare, and for search and rescue operations. Commando, the military transport variant. Lynx, a new multi-role helicopter of outstanding performance and agility. Westland 606, a new generation IFR civil helicopter based on Lynx. Gazelle, a high-speed, economic, easy-to-maintain helicopter for civil and military use. Puma, a well-proven tactical helicopter for support roles. In performance, in capability, these Westland helicopters are designed and built for the 80s. Westland Helicopters are the largest company within the group of Westland Aircraft Limited, a principal British aviation company since 1915, employing 12,000 people in aerospace activities. 25 years ago, the company turned to helicopter production. Now, Westland is one of the two largest helicopter producers outside the United States. Production line at Yeovil, Westland Sea Kings take shape. Right from the start, the future operator is established, and each helicopter is equipped to meet specific customer requirements. Inherent in every aircraft are many related skills, advanced technologies, and products from within the Westland group of companies. Hydraulic controls, pressurization, fuel, and electrical systems are fitted, together with thousands of assemblies and sub-assemblies. Sea King has many outstanding features. With twin Rolls-Royce Gnome engines, search radar and sonar equipment, automatic flight control, and powered blade folding, Sea King is in demand. And it's not surprising. But the true test of any new aircraft comes after operational experience. The Westland Sea King, chosen for the Royal Navy and the services of many countries throughout the world, is an operational and export success, fully justifying the British development of the basic Sikorsky design. Sea King is first and foremost a potent anti-submarine weapon system, developed initially for the Royal Navy. It carries British radar and sonar sensors, and can detect, classify, and destroy submarines in all weathers, by day or at night. Derived from this is the search and rescue version, with a search radius of 250 nautical miles, a cruise speed of up to 120 knots, and an all-weather, day or night flying capability. To fix a survivor's position and to direct the pilot, it's equipped with high-frequency homing equipment. An autopilot system holds the helicopter in attitude, height, and heading, and reduces pilot workload. The crewman can make critical adjustments to the helicopter position over the survivor. With 250 feet of cable on a hydraulic hoist, survivors can be lifted from difficult mountainous or wooded areas, as well as from ships or life rafts. The long-range, all-weather capabilities of Sea King make it ideally suited for North Sea oil rig operation. Commando, developed directly from Sea King, is in production for armed support, troop transport, and casualty evacuation. It meets the demand for a medium-sized multi-role helicopter capable of operating for long periods without base support. But out of years of design experience and technical development has emerged a helicopter that can claim to be significantly better than anything that has gone before. The Lynx. Designed and built by Westland in collaboration with Aerospatiale, it meets the most demanding worldwide requirements. It is fast, agile, and needs minimum maintenance. These features are the product of applied new technology. The most revolutionary new feature of the Lynx is the semi-rigid rotor, made possible by a single titanium forging. All the moving parts of a conventional helicopter rotor, except the feathering hinges, have been eliminated. Simple, elegant, and effective, the new rotor makes a significant contribution to the agility and performance of Lynx. A new streamlined airframe was designed, and the aerodynamic properties of the Lynx were thoroughly investigated in Westland's giant wind tunnel. This is used for a wide range of research and development activities. Measurements taken in winds of up to 143 miles per hour provided vital flight behavior information. Tests were thorough and exhaustive. To check and confirm design predictions, complete airframe structures have been subjected to stress, load, and vibration tests equivalent to 7,000 flying hours. This is but one of a whole range of test rigs used during the Lynx comprehensive fatigue and performance test program. Throughout the design and development stages, simplicity has been the keynote. This, in turn, has led to reduced maintenance and operating costs, longer in-life service, and higher performance. For example, the number of moving parts in the gearbox have been reduced by 40%. The low-profile, two-stage Lynx gearbox was designed, developed, and manufactured at Yeovil. It incorporates conformal gears, refined and developed to simplify the gearbox and to reduce maintenance. Two military variants are in production for the Army and the Navy. Both are powered by twin Rolls-Royce turbine engines designed specifically for Lynx. Both are structurally the same, but the Navy aircraft has a radar nose and wheeled undercarriage. The Army Lynx has skids and a conventional forward structure. The Lynx development program involved a total of 2,500 hours of test flying.
Right, you are. Thank you. 30 degrees, port and starboard, please. Okay, Mike.
Okay, port, 30 degrees and back.
From airborne helicopters, telemetry equipment receives and records essential flight information during flight tests. Day or night, the Lynx will fly in all weather conditions. Its speed compares with fixed-wing aircraft. It's the holder of two helicopter world speed records, having achieved speeds in excess of 200 miles per hour. At maximum all-up weight, it cruises at 185 miles per hour, and even 80 miles per hour backwards. Aerobatic barrel rolls are performed with ease, at rates in excess of 100 degrees per second. Exceptional performance, precision of control, handles like a fixed-wing aircraft. These remarks come from the people who can't, the pilots who fly the Lynx. New, fast, multi-role versatility. This is Army Lynx. Anti-tank strike, troop transport, casualty evacuation, logistic support and surveillance, no other helicopter can perform so many roles or change roles so quickly. Anglo-French cooperation has been evident throughout development. On the French naval frigate Tourville, Navy Lynx demonstrates its ability to operate from the restricted space of a small ship. An automatic, pilot-operated positive deck lock engages with a grid on the ship's deck. With the deck lock engaged, the Lynx can turn through 360 degrees and reposition for deck handling. With the aid of a new deck handling system, it can be quickly and easily stowed in the ship's hangar. In the anti-submarine role, Lynx can be armed with homing torpedoes, depth charges, and marine markers. With search radar and four missiles, in the anti-shipping search and strike role, Lynx effectively counters the threat of fast missile-carrying patrol boats. Together with search and rescue, a load-carrying and casualty capability, the Navy Lynx is destined for many years of operational service. Westland 606, a new civil helicopter, will carry up to 14 people and is based on Lynx technology. Designed for offshore operations and executive transportation, it's fast and economic to operate with all-weather capability. Already well established in the highly competitive civil field is the Westland Aerospatiale Gazelle. It's in production, in quantity, for civil and military use. As a five-place economic business transport or public service helicopter, Gazelle is an outstanding success. Over 60% of each Gazelle is manufactured by Westland, and nearly 500 have been ordered. The Gazelle has exceptional visibility and is able to maneuver in the most confined areas. Gazelle is in military service in Europe and the Middle East and is being manufactured under license. Together with Lynx and Gazelle, the Puma is also part of the Anglo-French collaborative helicopter program. A twin-engined tactical transport helicopter, it's in service with the Royal Air Force, the French Air Force, and other civil and military operators. Supporting well over 1,600 helicopters in service all over the world is Westland Product Support, a fully coordinated backup service.
The advantage of the rigid rotor, of course, is the...
It provides a comprehensive technical information and field service, ensuring that every Westland helicopter remains in active service at all times.
What's the part number? We'd better get an alert signal out.
Product support encompasses the provision of spare parts, stored and issued under computer control from a new high-density storage wharf. Nearly 90,000 production parts and spares will be quickly and easily available. Extensive training facilities, too, are provided, not only for maintenance engineers, but for flight crews. If necessary, Westland can provide customer pilot training, ranging from ab initio up to familiarization on the latest operational equipment.
Right. Well, we're all set for takeoff now.
Check it, Westland 1-2, takeoff.
And Westland 1-2, this is Jedwin Tower. You're clear to take off. The surface wind is westerly at 5 knots. QFE check 1015.
Designing, building, and organizing for the future, Westland helicopters are achieving their aim of an ever-increasing share of the world market. Exports account for well over half of the company's business. A product of British technology, of Anglo-French cooperation, and of long association with the United States. This is the range that is taking Westland helicopters into the 80s.